Hi Bob, I'm going to go ahead and just kind of do an evaluation. I'm going to have me up in the corner of your screen, so you're actually going to be watching me watching you play. And I really like this video. There was a lot of good points. There's a lot of things that you can work on that's going to make you a better player. Really didn't see a whole lot wrong with your mechanics, but a little bit with your strategy, a little bit with the speed of your stroke. We're going to cover that and just go ahead and dig right into this one. Okay, you're starting off, you're shooting this one ball. And I would have liked you like to see you stop and maybe shoot that strike ball instead of this one first. You come over and you kind of hit that to where you push that 10 ball back over to the rail. That could present a problem, but I think you dealt with that very well. You're back on what looks to be, I'm not sure if that's a 13 or the 9. We'll just call it the strike ball for now. And this is the ball I would have used to go up into those two balls, that two ball and that other strike ball that's next to it. And what you're getting ready to do on this shot right here, what you need to do is you need to contact one of these balls, not both of them like you do. See, if you would have just either knocked the 15 or knocked the 8 out of the way, I'm not sure, I believe that was the 11. If you would have just contacted one of them, you would have had a break ball up in that area. So what I want you to do right now is I want you to look at the rack area, and there's those two balls that are up in the center of the rack area, and I think you do a really good job getting a nice shot to where you can create a break ball. But other than that, you know, it's kind of bare up in that neck of the woods, so. That's a really nice shot right there. You pocketed that ball very well. You came back over to this eight ball. And what I like is that you saw this. I know a lot of players wouldn't see this, but you saw, you know, stop and then come over and create a break ball. But watch the speed of your shaft. See that? The speed of your shaft is going to be transferred to the speed of the cue ball. And that speed gets transferred to the object balls. So if you only want that ball to just gently tap it out, what you need to practice is controlling the speed of your shaft on the shot. That's the key to getting those balls to spread real nice and hitting them exactly where you want to hit them. Now, right here, it's not an ideal end pattern, but you did recognize that you have to use one of those balls that are in the side pockets as your break ball. I would have liked to use this ball here as my key ball. I would have went to shoot that 11 first and then use that as my key ball because I basically only have one rail position. I probably would have got a better angle. Here, what you need to do is you need to get below that eight ball. You actually want to be over in this area over here. From there, you're going to end up having to use the rail, and too many factors come in, and a lot of things can go wrong. And you want to minimize those factors. But you got out of that rack, and you've got a very workable break ball. Not one that I would recommend. I actually like getting the cue ball over in this direction. Pocketing that ball and hitting the top two balls. I'm just kind of skipping off the top of them. But you make this work for you. You do a very good job of making sure your cue ball goes where you intend it to go, or you intended for it to go. So here we go. In this shot here, you got to make sure you don't scratch. Come up and boom. So you got a few balls open, and what I like is the way that you're walking around the table. I really like that. You're looking at everything, you're examining the stack, you're looking for a dead ball, and you found one. And you're looking at the contact point that's going to start your chain reaction. This is good stuff right here. That's what's going to get those balls open, is looking for something that's going to just completely get the balls separated to where they're not touching. And that's a very nice stroke. You're right exactly where you need to be. You're going right back over. You're looking exactly where you need to hit this. And that's a lesson for a lot of players out there. Should really look at the way that you did this. And look. Now, you really didn't take care of the problem in the center there. But you do have, I believe that's a 15 ball that's over on the other side. And if there's one criticism in this rack that I can give you, it's that what I would have done in this situation is, because that 15's there, and because you're a right-hander, and you're breaking the balls over towards your end of the table, over there where that one ball is, you have three or four balls that are going to go over there anyway. What I would have done is I would have set up to pocket that 15, go into the 5, just to get those balls open a little bit sooner. You want them to go in the, when you go into a cluster or a group of balls, you want them to go in an area where it's going to be advantageous for you. And here, that was your error right there. A lot of people think that when your run ends, it's because of the shot you missed. Usually it's because of decisions like the one you made just there. Now, you're underneath the balls, but I want you to see how this works out for you. Because of where this disbursement's going to go once you hit this 12 ball, it looks like you're going to move your break ball. All those balls are moving in the direction of your break ball. So what you have to do is you have to look to see if there's a ball there that's going to replace that 15. And the shot is there. And you do everything correctly, except you follow through on this and look at the speed of your stroke and look where those balls are. And right now, you have very little left up in the rack area. The 15 is still there, but it's not in an ideal position. It's kind of closer to the rail. It's further away from the rack. And increased distance means decreased accuracy. But you go right into this pattern. You shoot this pattern exactly the way that you should shoot it. You start off with that strike ball. You come back up here. I believe that's either the 2 or the 4. That's where you should go next. And what I'm looking at, what I would concentrate on, is getting these balls off of the rails. The 13, the 1, and I'm not sure which ball that is down at the other end of the table. You got a little bit too much angle on this ball right here, so you have to be a little bit more careful than most of your other shots. Ideally, you want to go 13 to the 1, or you can decide to go all the way down to the other end of the table. What I like about the way that you do this, you watch your stroke, you make sure that you don't hit anything else. But still, you got to get those balls off of the rail. And you're taking your time. You're looking at what it is that you need to do. Myself, I'm looking to pocket that 15. I'm not gonna use that 15 as a break ball. It's just too complicated of a pattern. I would go from here. I would shoot the 15 off. I would go 15. Then I would get that strike ball that's in the center of the table. and then either go for the one and that strike ball that's down near that other corner pocket. I would use the five as my key ball and the eight or the six, I'm not sure which ball that is, that's closest to the side pocket. That would be my break ball. And I think this is another one of those tactical errors right here.
You still have a chance to salvage this by getting this one ball off the rail. Right here, I would go ahead and pocket the one and get straight in on that strike ball that's in the center of the table. That would line you up perfectly to come one rail to the center of the table for the five ball and to have that ball in front of the side pocket as your break ball. But you don't do that. You come over for that strike ball. And initially when I watched this, I believed that you saw the same thing that I did until I saw you draw this ball out like that. And here I'm still shooting that strike ball. I can still one rail it to center table to get on that five. There's no reason to pocket that ball. The one that you're looking at in the side pocket. That's a much better break ball than that strike ball was. And here you just let go of your cue ball. You're lucky you didn't scratch in the side. And there, you know, you're basically in no man's land and the run is over.
Okay, what you're gonna watch me do in this video is I've racked five balls in the rack area, left one break ball out. And you're going to see me go ahead and run these racks. Once I pocket this break ball, I'm going to spread these balls out. I can't hit them too hard because I basically want a break ball to develop right off the break shot. Once that break ball is off the table, I have to go immediately into my end pattern. And I have to plan accordingly and I have to look at the pattern that's going to get me on my next break ball. So it's imperative that I don't hit these balls very hard and send them all over the table. I want to basically keep them within this rack area to have a break ball develop here, 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 or here. It doesn't matter where it goes. I want to get on one. Okay, I want to get a break ball. A lot of people think that you got to go into the rack as hard as you can, splatter them all over the tables. Okay, it looks powerful. It's not very effective in the game of 14-1. You save that for your 9-ball break. Pay attention, as I said, to shaft speed. Pay attention to how fast your shaft is going through your bridge. That's how you're going to gauge how fast those balls are going to go and how much they're going to come apart. And watch, I don't have to hit this very hard at all. Okay, and right now I've got a break ball in the back. I've got a break ball over here. If I wanted to, I could probably nudge that six out, but I kind of like using that 10 ball. That 10 ball is probably the best option for me right now. So I'm going to go ahead and watch my shaft speed. I don't have to go too far. And bang, I'm right on that six ball. I just want to go over and across to get on the four. Okay. From the four, I want to get on the 13. Here, just want to follow forward, maybe get on this rail a little bit, try to just kind of put a little bit of left on this, have it come out to the rail, and now I'm going behind the stack, go ahead and rack these up, get out of the way, see what we have. Okay, you got a pretty good opportunity to get back into these balls. And like I said, it's all the speed of your shaft. You don't want these balls to splatter all over the table. You just want them to separate. And when you get that down, when you have that part down where you're not splattering the balls all over the table, this game becomes a completely different game. You're a little bit out of line, but I've got two break balls. There we go. And I'll do this, I'd say, for a good 15 to 20 minutes before I start practicing, just to get the speed of my stroke down, to always be in my end pattern. That's where your mind needs to be thinking, is in patterns. And you'd be surprised how this helps and how it aids you in not, you know, trying to shoot straight pool like you're playing nine ball, or you're not trying to break the racks up like you're breaking a nine ball rack. Here, I've got a little bit of distance here, but the same principles. Yeah, I kind of got stuck there, but I think I got a dead ball off this 11 to put it right here. Don't want to let go of my cue ball. I may or may not make this, but as long as you get the basic idea of what I'm teaching you. There we go, kind of messed that up. Here's another situation where we're going to rely upon the speed of our stroke to determine how these balls are going to spread. We've got this big cluster of balls right here in the triangle area, and we've got to take care of the problem. I want to go into these balls one time, but I don't want the balls to go all over the table. I don't have a break ball other than this five ball, and I'm going to be sacrificing that to spread the balls out. So once again, what we're going to rely upon to gauge the speed when we go into these balls is the speed of our shaft. And the speed of the shaft is going to determine where that cue ball goes and how it goes. So what we're going to do, pocket this one, and pocket the 15. Okay, now we're going to come back over here and we're going to check what we need to do and how we want to do it. Now we got this four ball here as an insurance ball. And just watch the speed here. Watch the speed of my shaft. I just need to get that five to drop. Now the only ball I'm going to contact is that 12. All right, you see how that worked out for me? I got the three ball to come out as a break ball. If I want to leave it there, I don't have to do anything to it. It's already there, okay? I've got the 10 ball over on this side of the table. If I want to leave it there, it's already there. Don't have to do anything to it. I've got some other shots. I've got six ball came down table. It's a little further down table than what I like it, but it's really not a problem. And that works out very well. Like I said, the speed of your shaft is going to determine how fast that cue ball goes. And here, just kind of, you see how slow the cue ball is going, how slow my shaft is going. That's the way I like to keep control of the cue ball. One of the things you'll notice about me is I always take the long way around the table. If I need to shoot this 12 ball and it's real easy to come this way, what I'll do is I'll actually walk completely around the table. That way I come over and I see exactly what I need to do with that ball. Keeps me from being one of those 14-1 statues or guys that don't look at the table. And here I've shot myself into a stop shot end pattern. And like I said, I'll take the long way just to kind of see what I have Sometimes I do get dizzy, but I like doing that. It slows me down, keeps me thinking. And when I don't do that, that's usually when I start running into problems with my cue ball control or my shot making. And I'll take the chop, walk completely around the table, take them the long way. And there we go. And it's the same thing with racking balls. I take my time, try not to think about the break shot too much. I just think about what I've just done and how I can keep it up. And you know, if you leave yourself a tough break ball and you're thinking, the only thing you think about is how you're going to miss it or how tough it is, you're going to shark yourself right out of the shot. I got a habit of just not looking at it until I get down over it. Come back over, like I said, taking the long way. Come over, get the chop. Come back over, look at where I need to hit it. Look at it from the other side. And some might say, you know, this will drive your opponent crazy, but you can never be too careful. You can never be too cautious in the game of 14-1. There, kind of pulling my cue ball back. Don't want to get caught on this rail. We'll come over. First thing I do is grab that chop. And we're going to come over and examine the stack here. I don't think I really have anything that's going to pop out of there. But what I do have is I have that 11 ball. And that 11 ball could be used to break the rest of those balls up. So I've got to look at how I'm going to get there. Now, one of the things you don't want to do in this situation is shoot this 15 and try to go into the balls or do too much with your cue ball. What you want to do on there, on that shot there, is you want to stop your cue ball. I like stopping it dead. And now that I've chose my shot, like I said, we take the long way. I'm going to come back over and I'm going to look at it from behind the pocket. Know exactly where I need to hit it, where I need to go with my cue ball. There we go. I'm using this 3 ball to work my way towards the 11. All right, when I'm here, I'm going to look to see what else I have. Okay, don't want to shoot the 11 right now. We've got plenty of time. We have plenty of opportunities to get over there. Here, I'm going to play this off of the rail. Okay. Now, I'm going to come back over on this side. I'm going to look at what I have. And I should be able to make this 12 off the rail. Kind of got my cue ball in a little bit of trouble here, but there we go. All right, now I lost the 11. No need to panic. Just try to go ahead and regroup. From where I'm standing, that 14 ball is dead. I've got to get back over here. I could do that shooting this 13 off the rail. I just have to come over here on top of the 8 ball. And I'm going to come over here and double check to make sure that ball goes. And I need to hit the 2 on that side. Just need to get my cue ball over there. There we go. Now here, once again, you don't want to hit this too hard. I'll hit that 2 ball on the left side, a little bit of follow, just like that. And notice how I kept my cue ball with that 2. I had the 4 come out, and I'm going to go around. I'm going to look or go around the table and see what I have to work with here.
Okay, go ahead and start this run here. I missed the first shot. I didn't get it on video.
Okay.
So I'm going to not count the first shot. You see, I'm shooting pretty fast.
Okay.
I was trying to get into a rhythm. I had to go do something. I was kind of in a hurry. And I wanted to get a good run on video for you to end this evaluation. And immediately after I did this run, we went out and we were in a pretty bad car accident. So I apologize I couldn't get something a little bit higher, but this is a pretty good run that kind of showcases some of the things that I went over within the evaluation. As you can see, I've got the balls open.
Okay.
I've got a pretty good break ball on that six ball, and I'm going to be clearing it out now, bringing my cue ball back to the center of the table to get that. I believe that's a 15 ball. I'm going to get that off the rail. And we go down table, and I basically have five key balls down there. It doesn't matter which one of these balls I leave for the last ball. I'm probably going to get a pretty good break shot on that six. Okay, and it looks like I'm going to go ahead and leave. I think that ball that's near the side pocket, I'm going to go ahead and leave that and just kind of draw into line with that six ball. And here, it's just pretty basic stuff, just kind of draw. Actually, I followed that. It's probably a better shot. I could have went either way with that. So like I said, immediately after this is when we had our car accident. And I was kind of in a hurry. It was getting kind of late, and we still wanted to go have dinner. And this rack here, I had a lot of problems because I didn't really contact the stick the way I wanted to. See that? I was kind of lucky that I hit that ball that's there in that lower right-hand corner pocket, or the cue ball probably would have scratched, and I think it should have. And there I went ahead and followed into the balls. Okay, now the main problem that I have here is those balls are on the left side of the table. I believe this shot here creates the problem. See what that three ball just did? That's a problem, and I'm going to try for the rest of the rack to separate the three from the 11. Mm-hmm. And I think I'm shooting a little bit too fast. I'm just sort of taking it for granted that I could use one of those balls that's near it to go into it. And there I tried to go back into the balls to create a break ball and really hit that seven ball. And that was kind of sloppy right there. And that was my lame attempt to try to separate the three from the 11. And now I'm kind of stuck. The only ball I have to break it up is my break ball. So right now I'm in trouble, shooting a little bit too fast, not paying attention to what was on the table. And see, now I'm going to try to get in there using a couple of rails and knocked into that ball and pocketed it, and I actually needed that ball. And there, lucky I didn't scratch into the side pocket. And now I got to sacrifice the break ball. And when I shot this, I figured I could knock that three ball kind of close, and right now it's kind of a high break ball. And this shot, I got a pretty good angle to knock back into that three and reposition it, but I'm kind of surrendering control. And look at this. That's not good. And I'm looking at it, and I could have probably tried to shoot that 15 and come up to use the 3 ball, come off the rail, but I decide to pocket the 3 and try to put the cue ball in the rack. And if you watch, I stand up right out of my shot and didn't get there. So, don't have a
cue ball in the rack.
Yeah.
I thought you were.
See how that worked out.
That didn't work out well at all. And what I'm going to try to do is pocket the 15. You see, I'm pretty pissed off at that, but as you'll see, I deal with it pretty well. The run is 28. I only have 27 on tape, so go ahead and pocket this ball, trying to come up with the cue ball to contact the stack, and I'm not able to do that, but I'm in perfect position to bank that first ball in the stack, the top ball. And there it goes. Banked it cross-side. Almost made the 6. And got a pretty good result. Just got to separate those balls that are kind of clustered there at the bottom of the rack area. I'm going to go down table, get rid of this 7 in an attempt to just kind of work my way up towards that cluster.
It's 28,
and,
number?
Yeah, because of that break shot, I didn't move my coin. I usually move the coin around the table to keep track of what my run is. And there, I've tried to get on that 6 ball that's in the corner pocket. I've got to basically just kind of skim it in there. And there, I kind of hit the point of the pocket and got sent down table. So now I got to come with a shot, and I'm going to try to go into the balls here. And strike 1, swing and a miss. I can go into the balls probably with that straight ball.
Okay.
Now just kind of follow forward. There we go. And I got 2 break balls. I got that 2 ball and I got the 11. Could choose to use either one. I'm going to go ahead and shoot off the 11. Probably the easiest shot I had on the table. In retrospect, I should have probably got that ball down table. Really doesn't affect my position for the next break ball. It's kind of basic stuff here. I just pocket these 2 balls and get on the break ball. And here I pocket this ball and come back out. Line up perfectly with my break ball. Should get into the next rack. And it's kind of funny.
Yep.
If... I'm the kind of person, I like to kind of stay in a rhythm as I go around the table. Kind of like to remain consistent in my pre-shot. And if you watch this, I don't even do anything. I just get down and one stroke this, and I miss it by about half a diamond. So, there it is, about 8 minutes.